Hello friend, welcome back. In our previous video, I already discussed about that things with you, how can create the controller. In this video, I will show you how can create the view page. For doing this, like here, that is our controller page. So for now, I just want to work for our view page. So finding out the view, you have to go the resources. And here you can see that is actually the view. So that is the by default welcome.blade.php. So that is actually our by default page. Like if you go to our main directory, now that is actually a by default one of the Laravel page. So right now I just want to create some of the view page. Like here into this position, I just create new file, and here I just click on the save as, and I just name it as about.blade.php. Okay, so you have to define that .blade.php for the inner Laravel if you want to create some of the page. So right now I just create one of the pages about. So now I just save it. And into this position, first of all, I just want to add one of the h1 tag, like as the about us page. Okay, so that will be our about us page. Here I just defining it, and I just click on the save all. And also I want to create another page, like here I just name it as a contact dot blade dot php, and I just save it. And this page I just name it as a contact us page. Okay, I just name it as a contact us page. So now if you want to display that page, like there is our about .blade.php. So if you want to display that page statically with the route, then how can actually do that work? Like here, first of all, you have to define the route. Okay, and then here you have to define the view. So here I just define the view, and into this position I just define our URL. So first of all, our URL I just assign as the about. Okay, so when I actually enter the about, then which page will be loaded? Like here I just define and that on here, then our about page will be loaded. Okay, so here I just define our about us page. So before, I already discussed about that things with you. Here you can see that is actually one of the view, and that is a welcome page. For the reasons, the by default welcome page is loaded when you actually enter the our home URL. So right now I just defining as a URL as a about, and here I just assign the lead we loaded about our about page. I already created one of the page as about in our views. So now let's check this out. I just copy it, that is our URL. So first of all, I just save all, and here right now I just assign our about, and now click on the enter. Yes, now we'll see now statically that HTML page is now visible on here. So that is our about us page. And now also, if you want to load our contact page, so then you have to define that things on here. So I just copied. Now I just want to put our URL as a contact. Okay, I just define the contact, and our page name here I have to define it. So our page as a contact. So here I just define the contact. And now if you click on the save all, and if you now want to browse that URL and on particular this position and click on the enter, now we see it's now showing as a contact us page. So I hope you can well understand about it. So now I just want to show you like how the route, controller and view page work together. For doing this, I just want to create another controller. Okay, like here there is our directory. So here I just define the cmd. So I already have that cmd. Okay, better I just cut it, and now here I just define the cmd again. And now here I want to create one of the controller for our about us page. Okay, so what exactly you have to do? You have to define the php and then the artisan. I just added the enter. Now you see the controller created successfully. So they have, I already discussed about that things with you. They have another system for creating the resourceful controller. So right now I just create one of the plain controller. Okay, so if you go our controller page, like here there is app, and then the stxs, then the controllers, and into the controllers here you can see there is a new controller added on particular disposition as a about controller. So for now I just want to update our route, like that is our view for the about us page. So right now I just also want to work with the view controller and the our route. So to get together how that things exactly work, I will show you. For the reasons we have to do, we have to define that things right now as a gate. Okay, and here there is our URL as a about, and into this position which method I want to access. For the reasons here they have another code, So I just also want to update it. Like then you have to define the uses. So I just define that uses. Okay, like here I just define that uses as a like here I just define as a single quotation. Okay, uses. So here I just define that uses and uses which controller. And also which controller, which method, you have to define that things on here. So I already created one of the controller as the about controller. So into the about controller here, I want to access one of the method like as the about method. So that the about method I have to create in our about controller. Okay. So here I just define that things on particular this area, that is our URL. And I just also define that uses which controller, which method. So here I just define that controller name and the controller method name on the particular disposition. And then I just also want to define this route, one of the name. So here I just allocated that things with as. Okay, so which name you want to define. So here I just define that name as a about. Okay, so for now I just define that as a about on particular disposition. So I hope you can well understand about it. So now we have to create this about method in our about controller. Okay, so in our about controller on particular disposition, I just define as a public and then function and then our method name. So here I just define that method. Okay, and into this position I just overloaded view this space, that means this our about us space. So that is the I assign on particular disposition as a about. So here I just defining it, like here I just return. Okay, I just return and then view and view which page. So here I have to define our page name. So here I just define that page as the about. Okay, so now if you click as a save all, and now if you actually access this URL, that means this about URL, then you will be well understand about it. Like here I just access that about. So now here there is unexpected this. So here you can see I miss that is actually bracket. I did that things on particular disposition perfectly, but here I miss it. So here you have to define that things. Okay, so for now I just click on the save all. So there is very much a simple mistake. And now I just refresh it. Yes, now you can see it's now redirected to our about us page. So I hope you can well understand about it, how the things exactly work. So into the position, I just get one of the URL as a about, and here I just define that uses, and uses means that which controller and which method you want to access. For the reasons here, I just define that uses, and here I just define that about controller in our about method. Here I assign that as a about, and into this position, I create this method as about method. And here I load our page, that means our view, and that is about us page. Okay, so I already created one of the pages as about in our view folder. So that is our about. For the reasons when you actually create a access this URL, automatically access this method, and into this method I just loaded that page. For the reasons is now actually showing on here. And now here if you want to make that things dynamic, like here if you want to pass some of the name for education purpose, I am just doing that things with using very simply one of the process, like in our controller, that is means that is actually our about controller, and in our about controller that is about. Okay, so here I also want to do, I just also want to assign one of the arrays. So here I just define one of the array, like I just putting some of the first name. Okay, first underscore name. And here I just putting the first name as a, for litigation purpose, I am using as a REN. Okay. And then I also define the another name as a last name. Last underscore name. And for the last name here, I just define that things as a fuzzy. Okay. So for now, I just putting two of this array on particular disposition. Now here I want to visible two of these in our about page, that means here. Okay, so for now I have to work on particular disposition. Like here, first of all, I just take one of the P. Okay, I just take one of the P and I define the first name. I just define the first name, and into this position I just take one of the PC block and close the PC block, and here I just echo our first name. Okay, so here I just defining two of these value on particular disposition as the first name and the last name. So here I just copy it, and in our about us space, so here I just defining this variable. Okay, so here I just define the first name, And also I have to finish that P, and here I just put on the bracket, then it's look better. Okay. And also I just copy the same things, and here I just defining as a last name, and I want to do like here there is our about controller, there is a last name, so here I just define that last name. Okay, so now if you click on the save all, and if you now go to here and if you click on the enter, now you can see it's now showing as a first name as a Aryan and last name as a Kazi. That means our router, view page and controller perfectly work together on particular disposition. So I hope you can well understand about it. And they have also another way, like here for now I just define the things with this as a array. Like when you have the multiple data, like if you have the lots of data, then you can also then use the compact. So how can do the same things with using the compact, I will show you. For if you want to work with the compact, like then first of all you have to write down as a like here, like I just define the first name, and here I have to define the first name as the Aryan. So here I just define that Aryan. Okay, so here I just define that Aryan. So here there is a first name. Now I just defined our last name. So here I just define that last name. Okay, and into this position our last name I just define as a Kazi. So now I want to do here, I just want to add the compact. Okay, so how can do that work? Like for doing this here, you have to write down as a compact. Okay, compact, and into this position you have to define your two variable. First of all is the our first name. So here I just define the first name, and then another one as the last name. So here I just define that last name. Okay, so if you have the multiple, like or if you have the lot of data, then you can use that compact, then this result will be the same. Like if you click on the save all, and if you now refresh that page, now you see it's now pretty much same things. So I hope you can well understand about it, how can use the compact. Okay, so for now it's perfectly working on here. So in our next video I will discuss about the blade template. So how the things exactly work, how we can actually working with the blade template, each and everything one by one I will show you with the live example. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.